Hello and welcome. My name is Magnus Oraka. Today I'd like to talk about something very significant in the issue of Nigeria today, and that is Christianity. It will not be far from the truth, if I say Christianity in Nigeria is gradually dissipating or is gradually becoming a mockery of what Jesus Christ anticipated or what Jesus Christ brought 2,000 years ago for us to worship. And if you think we could carry on like this, I want to tell you that if Christianity disappears today from Nigeria, it is not because Buhari has stopped Christianity, or Buhari has killed Christianity, or Islam has killed Christianity, or Fulani herdsmen have killed Christianity. It is because Christians themselves in Nigeria have destroyed Christianity. And I like to heap the whole of the blame, a great portion of the blame, to certain aspects of Christianity, and one of them is Pentecostalization. I'm so sorry to say that the whole idea of Pentecostalism in Nigeria has become a mad display of psychotic behaviors, rather. And again, I also want to say here that if Christianity dies today in Nigeria, you should hold Redeemed Christian Church and Bishop or Pastor Adeboye in particular responsible for where Christianity is tending. Now, you may choose to unfriend me or hate me, but I've been debating in my mind whether I should do this or not do it. In fact, my wife has said, don't do it, don't do it, don't do it. But my mind and conscience have been pricking me, do it, because somebody has to say the truth. Somebody has to say the truth, that the influx of fake pastors into the whole idea of Christianity is going to kill Christianity if someone does not stand up and talk. And I believe God is using me to say this to the whole idea of Christianity in Nigeria. Now, I wouldn't have minded much about saying this topic if it is not affecting the polity and the docility of most Christians in Nigeria when it comes to politics. Yes, docility in the sense that when it comes to politics, we tend to lose the sight that Christianity is at the brink of total disappearance. Now, I'm not saying that the Orthodox churches don't have their own problems. They do, but to some extent, it doesn't affect the polity or where the polity of Nigeria tends. But Pentecostalism has become a total madness and a total sham. I can tell you that for the past 5 months, I've lost interest in going to church, because what is the same thing? You see pastors who are sucking demons out of breasts, pastors who are dipping fingers into human women, their female, the members of their congregation who are female, dipping hand into their private parts in the guise of wanting to remove demons. You see pastors who say who have attributed godly attributes to themselves, pastors who now somehow are bigger than God. Pastors who have turned the whole idea of Christianity into a big business empire, and we all sit down and they seem to hide under the verse that say, touch not my anointed. The verse say, touch, not criticize. Now, for any man of God that is doing what is wrong, I will criticize and I will point that out. Pentecostalization of churches in Nigeria have become something that somebody has to speak out. And if God has taught me to speak, I will be the one to speak. How do you explain Christianity in Nigeria if it can produce somebody like the vice president, who is a total disgrace or a total disappointment to what Christianity holds? Christians are losing their lives every day, and the person we have in power cannot talk. Instead, he makes cases for the lives that have been lost, and that is a member of the Redeemed Christian faith. Last time I was surfing the internet, and I saw a picture portraying Pastor Adeboye and Buhari that they are revising the Bible together. How does that? You're trying to make good somebody who cannot hold peace, who cannot safeguard the life and citizenry of his country, trying to make case for him, and you said you are a man of God. Let me tell the world that the man they call Pastor Adeboye has departed from God. Yes, I said so. He has departed from God, and Christians in Nigeria need to pray for him to come back. What is engulfing Nigeria as a whole is a very strong and potent psychosis that has turned most Christians to the point that they can't reason very well. Now let me summarize everything. There's what we call black psychology, and when we talk of black psychology, we should relate that to Nigerian black psychology. The black psychology is such that the mentality of the black man has no connecting synapse. Now, a synapse is a neuron in the brain that connects. Each synapse connects to form a digit of idea, and that's what forms intelligence. Now, the connecting synapse of a black man is not as complex as that of a white man, which is why you see when a black man confronts challenging situation that the mind cannot reason rationally to the end, he tends to give it supernatural or spiritual explanation, which is why our Nigerian pastors have discovered that Nigerian populace, the black Nigerian populace, lack proper connection of synapse or proper logical strength or proper brain function, so much so that they are exploiting the inability of a black man to reason deep into peculiar life situations them, which is why a pastor can ask his congregation to drink jik, a poisonous substance in the guise that is removing demons. It is totally absurd where Christianity is standing with our men of God today. They say God called them. Where were they when God called them? Who was there when God called them? How do we prove God called them? If God actually called you, how have you become a menace to the people you serve? If God called you, why are you sleeping with your female congregants? If God called you, why are you using your congregation as footmat? If God called you, why are you subjecting your congregation from drinking poisonous substance in the guise of delivering them from some hopus corpus demons? What I see today's pastor is perhaps, I don't know if it is difficulty of the times, if it is because Nigeria is in total shambles, and therefore people are looking for easy means to get money. Because if you take away tithe today, the church will collapse. Because a great deal of pastors who are doing today's God work are actually not sincere. And you find a great deal of them in the Pentecostal church. I am so ashamed that it has turned to this. And somebody must stand up and talk. And I, Magnus Oraka, believe God is using me to say this. Pentecostalism in Nigeria has become a madhouse. And there must be some form of decency that should come into it if at all we want to sustain Christianity in Nigeria. I said in some videos in the past that in 2011, the only time that Christianity found a way to come together has lost its grip because of the great plan and penetration of the enemy. Now we have a Christian Association of Nigeria, CAN, which is more or less like a fancy body, like a picture on the wall that wouldn't do anything. If you call them toothless bulldog, you're even upgrading them, because even a toothless bulldog can emit some fear. This, we don't even have a toothless bulldog. We don't even have a dog. What we have is just a picture hanging on the wall. We don't have a body. When we had Orisha Jaffo there, at least we had some sense of opposition. But now we just have a can that goes to visit the very person that is killing them. Do we really have is this what you call Christianity? If this is what is called Christianity, then I fail to go to church. I will not go to church again. Christianity needs urgent sanitization. And I'm calling you, man of God. If you are there because you are just there to collect the money of your congregation, may the true spirit of God catch you and drop and die immediately. If you are there as a man of God, claiming you are called by God, but you are there because you want to fulfill your erotic desires by sleeping with your female congregant. May God make you die. If you are there as a man of God because you are looking for cheap popularity, and therefore you are willing to sell the interests of Christianity in order to prove you are loyal to the caliphate, who are hell-bent to make Nigeria, the rest of Nigerians, as subservient to them, may you drop down and die. Pastor Adeboye, I made a video to you some years ago, and I'm making this one to you again. You are a man of God that was seen as the leader, some unspoken or unconscious leader of the church. And you were targeted. And through you, Christianity has been broken. And yet you're doing nothing about it to bring Christianity back together. I look forward to the day where you will say, okay, Pastor Oyedepo, Pastor Onenche, Pastor this, Pastor that, let's come together and say no to what is happening to Christianity. It will stop that very day. But no, you want to enjoy the fraternity you have by going into Aso Rock and coming back, and that's all. My dear brother, I know you have attained a position where your followers will say that the wrath of God will smite me for daring to come. I don't buy that crap. You are failing and you are failed. And somebody must look into your eyes and tell you that, Adeboye, you are failing the church and you must repent now. You must repent now. If you are subducing people, if you have sown fear into people, it's just cheap fear. Sorry, that fear is not in me. Somebody has to tell you. And God is touching me to tell you, I am not, you may not want to describe me as born again or as spiritual, as holy, as, but somebody has to speak to you. The church is falling under your watch. Somebody has to talk to you. The church is falling under your watch, Mr. Adeboye. I am not going to insult you. All I'm asking is that may God touch you so that you go back. Come back to your calling. This idea of you need 10 people to bring 10, 1 billion naira, want this. The whole idea of Christianity is not to raise money. The whole idea of Christianity is to liberate people from their sin. And then Jesus Christ said, a new commandment I bring unto you. Love your God with all your strength, with all your mind. And love your neighbor as yourself. That is the whole tenet of Christianity. Anything outside that is addition. So in conclusion, I want to say that if you're a member of a church and you are attending Pentecostal church, get your senses back. You know, the black race, we cause the problem of our lives, and then we want quick solution to it after being responsible to our problem. It doesn't work that way. If you give birth to a child that has no proper upbringing, that has no proper education, no proper skills, and then the same child goes to church praying for God to make him a millionaire, how does that work? There's no such thing. That is not a miracle. That is not a miracle. You don't reap where you don't sow. So, if you didn't go to school and you want to become a millionaire, go to school even at your old age. Rebuild yourself and repackage yourself. No any man of God can pray to you and make you drink things and make you get miracle. You walk on the streets and somebody calls you and say, receive 10. Then you come to church and you give testimony. Say, when I was working one day, I met one man and blah, blah, blah. Something happened. He gave me a contract of 50 million. Those are fairy tale stories. They don't work. If anybody's giving that testimony in church, it's a planned work. So I want the idea that today Christianity stopped deceiving docile Nigeria, gullible Nigerians. The population of those docile Christians is alarming, which is why the enemy can come and tell you lies and vote for him, and you see Christians going to vote for what will kill them. Somebody has to talk. Pentecostalization in Nigeria has become a madhouse. Sanity needs to come to Pentecostal churches now. And one other thing. I've seen, I want to, yes, they are not perfect, they are human, but at least they stood up against tyranny. Suleiman, Israel Buba, Enenche, Oyedepo, a few of men of God who have stood up against tyranny. I want to say thank you and God bless you. But you are individualizing the fight. A fight individualized will not yield anything. What is so difficult for you coming together and say, we as a Christian body, we say no to what is going on. And everything will stop. But when some group are saying no, one group are saying yes.